Andy, good morning. Thanks for answering my last question on the social situation of development. That was great. I have another one for you now. And it goes like this. How could a skeptic or a critic of Marx's economic analysis have faith in Vygotsky's psychological analysis, given the likelihood that there's some overlap between the two, be it methodological or otherwise? Andy, looking forward to your response. Take it easy. Thanks.
If someone has actually studied Marx, you've read the Communist Manifesto, you've studied Das Kapital, and they're familiar with what Marx has said, and they've reflected on all the changes that have taken place over the past 200 years, and they come to the conclusion that they reject Marx's analysis of capitalism, then I wouldn't be confident that they're going to understand or get something out of Vygotsky. But I think it's more likely the other way around. Suppose someone has only maybe dabbled a bit in Marx. I've heard a lot of secondhand opinions about him. They may be more familiar with the Soviet Union or what some Marxist they know has told them. But they have first-hand experience of child development. They're an active teacher. They know about learning. They interact with teachers, second language learning, and they have a visceral experience of their own on these topics. Then I would be confident that they will learn a lot and they will value Vygotsky. And I'll then say, I wonder if someone who accepts Vygotsky's ideas about psychology might learn something from Marx, which deals with topics that are actually quite remote from their personal experience.